we gather together in the name of Christ, we pray for the world he came to save, for the Church, that it may be enabled in our generation to surrender anew to God's holy wisdom and bear the good news of God's love to a needy world. For the world, which is already Christ's, that all its people may recognize their responsibility for its future and may be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom, and peace everywhere. For all in special need, the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful, those who are near death, and the bereaved, that the peace and light of the Christ child may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. We commend all whom we love or who have asked for our prayers to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father, and say together as Christ himself taught us, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Our first reading is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 1 to 7. But there will be no gloom for those who are in anguish. In the former time he brought into content the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the latter time he will make glorious the way of the sea, the land beyond Jordan, Galilee of the nations. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with the joy of the harvest. As people exult when dividing plunder, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Thank you.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in the womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord."
Thank you.
much. It is wonderful for us to be here at this time of year, especially after this year, with the fires at the beginning of the year and the eventual lockdown with COVID-19 and everything that has followed from that, to be here now at this time of year to celebrate the hope which is in the Christ Child in this particular service is most special for all of us. But as we do celebrate this night, as we look forward to our own Christmas celebrations with our own families now that we're allowed to travel, all of these things come together with the hope and the knowledge of Christ within us. So we look forward. We don't look back. All of the things that have been in the past are in the past. We now need to look forward with hope, with an understanding that it is possible to come to terms with things like peace, to come to terms with things like ensuring that there is access for all to immunisation, to come to terms with actually dialoguing and listening to others, because we have had to do that in our own isolation, listening to those who have proclaimed, who have talked over radios and telephones, to cheer us up, to keep contact with us, and to understand that we are not alone. And this is perhaps one of the things, the best things coming out of COVID-19. We have contacted each other in ways that we didn't dream of contacting beforehand. We accepted that we would see each other at church, at social functions, in the shops, etc. But one of the things that COVID-19 should have done for us and should open our eyes is that there are other ways of communicating. There are other ways of maintaining our own social interactions. And those are most important if we wish to continue to be a community in Christ. A community that demonstrates God's love, a community that demonstrates the incarnation of Christ within our hearts and within our lives. And so as we go forward from today, reminding ourselves that all of this has shown us the path which has led to the Christian story and shown us the path of our faith journey. Let us tread forward from here in faith, in hope, and in love. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for this night. We thank you for allowing us to be here and gathered together. And may we shine as a light in the world when it comes to our future, a future blessed by your presence in our lives. We ask this through him who is to be born in the Bethlehem. Amen.
lesson is from Luke to verses 3, verse 1 7. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Messiah was to be born. They told him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may go and pay him homage. When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you. this from the Philippians chapter 4, beginning at verse 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honourable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. And the God of peace will be with you.
Thank you.
comes from John chapter 1, the beginning of verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Before I move to the final blessing, I think we need to show our appreciation to not only James, but also David, Anthony, and Benedict for their voices and music this evening. Please pass on our best wishes to Andrew as he copes with two twins, one set of twins, rather, when they eventually come. I would ask the congregation to please stand. We believe that the Son of God once came to us. We look for him to come again. May his coming bring you the light of his holiness and free you with his blessing. May God make you steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and untiring in love all the days of your life. We rejoice that our Redeemer came to live with us as man. When he comes again in glory, may he reward you with eternal life.